Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're diving back into the world of aviation weather, and we're going to learn how to decode a TAF, or Terminal Aerodrome Forecast. It is essential as pilots that you can decode this information. So we'll look at a couple of examples of a TAF, and we'll break it down line by line, running through what each of the codes mean, and hopefully you'll get a grasp of the kind of information and the format that's being used. There is quite a long list of codes that are used in TAFs and METARs, so I will create a document which I will post into the channel Discord server. So let's get started and take a look at an example of a TAF from London Luton, Echo Golf Golf Whiskey. We can get this information through our EFBs like I have here, our MCDUs or other subscription services such as Navigraph. So what exactly is a TAF? A Terminal Aerodrome Forecast is an aviation weather forecast for an airport. It tells us what kind of weather pilots can expect at a specific location over a certain period. TAFs are issued four times a day and typically cover a 24-hour period. TAFs use a standardized format to provide critical details like wind, visibility, cloud cover and significant weather events. So let's break down this example of a TAF we have on our screen here. First of all, we have the type of forecast, so it is a TAF, a Terminal Aerodrome Forecast, and we have AMD. So AMD stands for amended. This means the TAF has been amended from its original version due to significant changes in the forecast. Next we have the airport ICAO code, Echo Golf Golf Whiskey or London Luton. Next we have the date and time that the TAF was issued. So the 13 is the stands for the day of the month, so it's the 13th of March here, so it's the 13th day of the month at 09:03 Zulu. These are always issued in reference to Zulu time, which is the same as UTC. Next we have the forecast validity period, and this forecast is valid on the 13th day of the month at 0900 to the 14th day of the month at 0600, and that is again in Zulu time. So it's a 21-hour period for this particular forecast. Current winds 350 degrees true at 8 knots. So the first three digits here are the wind direction, and this is in relation to true north and not magnetic north. We touched on this in the METAR video, and I showed you where you can get the variation from in that video, so do check that out. And then we have our wind speed, the last two digits, and KT stands for knots. Next we have our visibility. So where you have four nines, that means visibility is 10 kilometers or more. If you were to see 0500 here, that would mean visibility is 500 meters. In the US, they measure visibility in statute miles. So you will see SM after the figure displayed there. And then we've got BKN, that stands for broken. So this is our cloud cover. So broken clouds at 008, which is 800 feet above ground level. And always remember, it's really important that the cloud measurement is from the airport ground level. So if you're flying on Q1H, you'll need to factor in the height of the airfield above the ground into any cloud-based calculations. On the next line, we have BECMG. That means becoming. So a gradual change is expected. And that change is expected on the 13th day of the month at 0900 up until it's the same day at 1100 Zulu. And what's changing is next. So clouds will become scattered at 2500 feet. Then we have tempo. This means temporary conditions lasting less than an hour at a time. And that's expected between 0900 and 1200 Zulu on the 13th. And those temporary conditions you can expect to encounter is a reduction in visibility. So we have visibility here of 6000 meters, 6 kilometers. And we have SH, which means showers, and RA, which means rain, so rain showers. So reduction in visibility and rain showers potentially coming in between 0900 and 1200. Then on the next line we have a cloud base, which is broken at 1200 feet. And then we have prob, so that's the probability and a percentage. So there's a 30% possibility of temporary conditions from 1200 to 1900, which is 6,000 meters of visibility, 6 kilometers. Rain showers, SH showers, RA rain. And then we've got showers, rain, RA, and GS. And GS is small hail. So there's a 30% chance that we'll encounter rain and hail showers with visibility of 6,000 meters between 1,200 and 1,900 Zulu on the 13th. Then on the bottom line, we have another temporary condition, and that's in place from the 14th of the month, from midnight until the 14th of the month at 0600. So that's visibility of 6,000 meters and a 30% probability that between 0300 and 0600 there'll be 3,000 meters of visibility and BR. And BR is mist. So to summarize what we're seeing here, if we're planning a flight in or out of London Luton, this forecast tells us that the wind is currently calm at 8 knots from the north. There's a chance of showers and even small hail, and mist may reduce visibility early on the 14th. So there's a worsening picture as time goes on. So let's go and look at our arrival TAF. Today that is for Salzburg Airports, Lima Oscar Whiskey Sierra. A bit longer than the last one. So again at the top we have the type of forecast. So Terminal Aerodrome Forecast for Lima Oscar Whiskey Sierra, Salzburg. And this forecast was issued on the 12th at 1715 Zulu and is valid from the 12th at 1800 hours until the 13th at 1800 hours. So a 24-hour period. Wind is currently from 310 degrees true at 8 knots. And then we've got CAV OK. CAV OK means ceiling and visibility OK. And that means essentially that visibility is at least 10 kilometers with no significant weather and no clouds below 5,000 feet. Then we've got TX09 and a time. So this means that the maximum temperature of 9 degrees is expected at 1800 Zulu on the 12th. So that's what the TX code means there. Then over here we've got TN05, and this is the minimum temperature, which is 5 degrees, that's expected at 0900 on the 13th. Then we have becoming between 1800 and 1900 on the 12th. Variable winds, so VRB, variable at 3 knots. Then we have a temporary condition, which again lasting less than an hour, between 2200 and midnight on the 12th. And that is RA, so rain, broken clouds at 1,400 feet. Then we have FM, which means from the 13th at midnight, we have winds at 330 at 8 knots, 8,000 meters of visibility. Got RA for rain, the minus means light, so light rain showers. Few clouds at 800 feet, overcast at 1,100 feet. Few and ABC, so different layers of cloud. Then we have another temporary condition on the 13th at 00, so midnight until 0400 on the 13th, which is 3,000 meters of visibility, rain, scatter clouds at 400 feet, which are broken at 800 feet. And then we've got becoming between 0800 and 1,000 hours Zulu on the 13th, change in wind direction to 340 at 5 knots. We've got NSW, which stands for no significant weather. Few clouds at 1,000 feet, which are broken at 1,600 feet. And a 40% probability that there will temporarily be between 1,100 and 1,600 Zulu on the 13th. And we've got few clouds at 4,000 feet. And these are cumulonimbus clouds, CBs. So one to watch out for there. And then we have another temporary condition lasting from 1300 Zulu to 1800 Zulu on the 13th. As a change of wind to 330 at 8 knots. Light showers, so you've got the minus, which is light. Light showers of rain. And a 30% probability of temporary conditions between 1400 Zulu and 1600 Zulu on the 13th of TSRA. So TS is thunderstorms and RA is rain. So thunderstorms with rain. And another temporary condition between 1500 and 1800 Zulu on the 13th of showers and rain. So temporary showers. Quite a lot to take in with that one. There's a lot of temporary changes. You can see as time goes on, the weather conditions are becoming more unsettled. So if we're planning a flight into Salzburg today, we'd look at this and we'd say the wind is variable but generally calm. There's a chance of rain showers, thunderstorms and low clouds, and the visibility may drop at times, especially within rain showers. So you'll see there's a lot of different codes in there, and it's impossible to sort of talk through them all on the video. So I will link a document through with those on into the Discord server. So I hope that little breakdown there makes it easier for you to read aviation weather forecasts. If you found this video helpful, please be sure to like, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more aviation content. And let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching.